world in electric amusement. The seaside links of Scotland's Royal Troon Golf Club, rugged in design yet equally spectacular. Its eighth hole, the fabled postage stamp, exemplifies Troon's motto, as much by skill as by strength. Arthur Havers kept the cup at home in 1923. Bobby Locke performed best in Troon's calm conditions in 1950. American dominance at Troon began in 1962, when Arnold Palmer defended the title and inaugurated golf's modern era. Incessant rain slowed the course in 1973, ideal for Tom Weisskopf's elegant power. Troon's 11th proved the turning point in 1982 for the fourth of Tom Watson's five open championships at the recently regalized Royal Troon. In 1989, Mark Calcavecchia fended off Greg Norman's challenge in a playoff for victory. The crowds, the spectacle, the history, and the mystique of golf's oldest major, the Open Championship, return to Troon as we approach the millennium.
The links style layout at Royal Troon features much of the outgoing nine played alongside the sea, with the incoming nine looping back further inland. The first fairway is bordered on the right by the Firth of Clyde and by two fairway bunkers that can come into play down the left side. The drive here should be played safely down the right center of the fairway. The short approach must elude the bunkers sitting on either side of this green. The second, a deceptively good driving hole, requires a tee shot that must carry over rough to reach the fairway. Care must be taken to avoid the two bunkers that guard the landing area of this hog's back fairway. The rough on the left holds mounds that can come into play with a pulled or hooked drive. This hole offers the option of laying up short to avoid the two fairway bunkers or trying to drive through them. The approach shot into this circular green must carry the three cross bunkers that sit short of the putting surface. The three greenside bunkers subtly guard for any weak shots which stray left or right. Number 3 offers a hint of things to come at Royal Troon. The fairway becomes increasingly narrow as the rough starts to creep in here. The tee shot must be kept short of the gorse burn and safely right of the two bunkers guarding the left side of the fairway. The preferred line off this tee is down the right side of the fairway short of the burn. The short approach here must be carried onto the green to escape two bunkers on the left side and one on the right. This reachable par 5 has a deep bunker positioned right in the neck of the dogleg to foil any attempt to cut the corner too close. The key here is to keep the drive away from the bunker, but not too far left, or the ball will run out of the fairway. The choice of whether to go for this green is left to the longer, more accurate hitters. The prudent second shot should be hit to the right of the left-hand fairway bunker, depending on the pin position. This leaves a short approach into the green. This small split-level green is protected by three bunkers, one on the left and two on the right. It has a definite slope away along the left side around to the back of the green.
You can reach the green in two if you hit a smoker off the tee. Just stay left of the fairway bunker, unless you're gonna fly it. A few mounds on the right side. Keep them in mind.
The fifth hole is the first of four very tough par threes. There is a bunker short and left of the green and two more very deep bunkers sitting next to the green. The right side is protected by yet another deep bunker. The tee shot here needs to be as straight as possible and must be carried onto the putting surface. The sixth hole is a brutish par 5 that plays as the longest hole in British Open competition. The landing area off this tee falls from right to left toward a pair of large fairway bunkers. Another bunker lies in wait on the right side of the fairway. The preferred line off the sixth tee is down the right side. A long line of high dunes covered in impenetrable rough runs along the right side of this ever-narrowing fairway. Two more nasty bunkers sit about 50 yards from the green. The out of bounds begins beyond the sandhills on the right and runs round the back of the green. The approach must be pitched to a long narrow green nestled into the sandhills. There is a small bunker protecting the left side of the green.
Stay to the right centre of the fairway and thread one between the bunkers.
The par 4 7th, a fine-looking dogleg right hole, requires an accurate drive between the four cross bunkers that guard the narrowing fairway. The preferred line off this tee is left of the right fairway bunkers. The approach to this well-bunkered, elevated green is testing even to the professionals. The postage stamp is the signature hole here at Royal Troon. Short in length but long in character, a par score of 3 here at number 8 is something to be earned. The narrow green sits tucked into the side of a large sandhill and is surrounded by 5 very dangerous bunkers. The tee shot must carry softly onto the middle of this green. Missing the green is not a good option here. The dogleg right par 4 ninth has an extremely undulating fairway bordered by large mounds and patches of gorse on both sides. The out of bounds runs along the right side and wraps around the back of this green. Two large mounds dominate the landing area and two fairway bunkers protect the left side. The ideal line off the tee is just short of the bunkers. The approach to the green needs to be played precisely to a rather small target. Any shot landing short and right here will feed into a large grassy gully. And be careful not to go off the back of this green.
The fairway bunkers on the left are a good target, but you'll want to lay up short with a fairway wood or long iron.